Welcome to this Beloved Tribe All Level Vinyasa Flow class. I'm so happy that you're here with me, and we're going to make a nice practice again today. For today, I would like you to ask you to get a blanket and a block or a book, something you can use to elevate your hips later in the practice. So if you haven't got that yet, please take some time to get it, pause the video, and get your stuff together, and then we meet up on the mat. We're going to start today by sitting in hero's pose. So that's with your legs folded underneath you. If you have some knee issues, you can also roll up the blanket and place the blanket between your legs, or sit on a block or a pillow, whatever feels best to you for your body. So come sit in hero pose, close your eyes, and we're going to land into the practice and start by first arriving on the mat. So maybe you want to wiggle around a little bit and feel like you have your right position, and then find your stillness in the position. And breathe your normal natural breath for a couple of breaths in and out to arrive in the space on your mat. Thanking yourself already for taking this time for yourself, for your body, to do this practice. And be here with yourself. And I want to start with a breath exercise. And this is a full yogi breath exercise with some breath retentions in the middle. So that means we're going to breathe in three parts and breathe out fully in one part. And the breathing in three parts is breathing in fully, first breathing in the belly, three counts, then breathe into the side ribs, three counts, and then breathe into the chest, and then breathe out in one go. So I will give an example. So breathe in for three counts in the belly, stop, breathe in through the side ribs, stop, breathe into the chest, stop, and breathe out in one go. You can do that with your mouth closed or mouth open, what feels best for you, and I will count it. So breathe in normally in and out for one time. And together start the breathing in your belly. One, two, three, stop. Breathe in your side ribs. One, two, three, stop. And breathe into your chest. One, two, three, stop. And breathe out fully. All the air out. And again, breathe in your belly. One, two, three, stop. Breathe into your side ribs. One, two, three, stop. And breathe into your chest. One, two, three, stop, and totally breathe out. And again, breathe into the belly. One, two, three, stop. Breathe into your side ribs. One, two, three, stop. Breathe into your chest. One, two, three, stop. And breathe fully out, all the air out. One last time, breathe in through the belly. One, two, three, stop. Breathe into the chest, side ribs. One, two, three, stop. And breathe into the chest. One, two, three, stop. And fully and totally out. And come back to your normal breathing. Take some time to feel how this breathing exercise lands in your body, the difference before and after the exercise. You can keep your eyes closed if you want, or have a soft gaze, what feels best to you. And the out-breath, bring your chin down to your chest. And on the in-breath, slowly make half circles with your neck, one side, breathing in, breathing out, come back to the center, down, breathing in, half circle to the other side. And in your own pace, make half circles with your neck. Breathing in, going up, and breathing out, going down. And keep it going. Full stretch of the neck. Maybe if you have no neck complaints, you can see if you can make the round fully. Breathing in, going up all the way overhead. Breathing out, coming down. Circling one way for a couple of times. Breathing in, coming up, all the way up. And coming down on an out breath. And when you're down, move to the other side. So change direction. Breathing in, coming up through the other side. And breathing out, moving down through the other side. The other direction. One more in and out breath. And slowly come up into neutral position. Going to make some cat-cow movements, sitting in this position. So place your hands on your knees. And in-breath, hollow out your back. Draw up your nose to the ceiling and come into a cow position. And breathing out, doming the spine. Bring your chin to your chest. Keep your hands on your knees, stretching out your arms and coming into cat. Move with your own breath. Breathing in for cow. And breathing out for cat. And if you practice with us last time, last week, we did the same practice, but then sitting in cross-legged, and see if you can find, feel the difference in your body doing it sitting like this or sitting in cross-legged position. Subtle changes, subtle alteration of your sitting position can make a lot of difference. Breathing in, coming up for cow. And breathing out, doming the spine, coming to cat, chin to chest. One more cow, and one more cat. Meeting back in the middle, neutral position, straight spine. Your pelvis is tucked in a little bit, so your tailbone is tucked in. Straight spine, chin is tucked in a little bit, so your whole spine is straight and stacked. Going to make little circles with your spine, your whole torso, starting one side, one direction, starting small, and gradually make the circles bigger. Breathing in, coming the front, and breathing out, doming through the back. See if you can make the circles maybe even a little bit bigger, as big as you can, tilting the pelvis to the back and to the front. And slowly make the circles a little bit smaller, coming back to neutral. And go the other direction. So if you went right, now you go left, or the other way around. Starting small, breathing in, coming to the front, and breathing out, coming to the back. Make them a little bit bigger. bit bigger if you can. Try to use the whole range of your pelvic area and your spine to dome everything out and to hollow everything out and to warm the whole torso up. And slowly come back to smaller circles and back to the middle. Place your left hand on your right knee. Inhale, lengthen and exhale. Come into a twist, looking to the back of your mat. You can place your right hand on tended fingertips on the floor, or maybe make a bind. Bring your right hand towards your left thigh and take hold of your clothes or your thigh, wherever your hand lands. See what feels best to you. Make sure you keep your sacrum tucked in. So do not dome the spine or hollow out the spine too much. Keep a straight spine, breathing into your base, into your belly. Gentle twist, don't force yourself too much. It's still warming up. And on an exhale, look to the front and come out of the twist. Going to the other side, place your right hand on your left knee. Lengthen on an inhale, on an exhale, place your left hand behind you on tended fingertips and look over your left shoulder for a side twist. And maybe if you want, you can bind your left hand, place it on your right thigh or take hold of your clothes wherever your hand lands. It's a bit of a bigger stretch in the shoulder area of the left side if you take the bind. Keep on breathing through your belly. You can use the Ujjayi breath through the whole practice, your ocean breath, breathing in and out with a slight constriction in the throat so you can hear yourself breathing. It can help you through the poses. And on your next out breath, look to the front and come back to neutral position. Going to warm up the shoulder area. Breathing in, bring your hands in front of you in Kali Mudra and bring your arms up on the in-breath. Stretch out your arms beside your ears. And breathing out, bring them down. And on the in-breath, bring your hands to the back, also in Kali Mudra, so your index finger sticks out. And on the in-breath, bring your arms up and away from the body, stretching out the shoulders. And on an out breath, bring them back in neutral position. Breathing in, bring them to the front. Index fingers pointing out and bring them up and overhead. Stretching them out. Upper arms are clasped towards the ears. And on an out breath, bring them down. Moving to the back. Bring your hands in Kali Mudra, in the bind. Breathing in, stretching out. Arms are up and away from the body, bringing the shoulder blades together, squeeze them together, and breathing out, let go. One more time, breathing in, clasp your hands in Kali Mudra in front of you, and bring your arms up and overhead, stretching out, make yourself as long, as tall as you can. Breathing in, full yogi breath, and breathing out, bring your arms down. Last time, to the back, clasp your hands in Kali Mudra. And on an in-breath, bring your arms away from the body, stretch them out, squeeze your shoulder blades together. And an out-breath, gently let go. Maybe you want to shake it out a little bit, your wrists. Very good. So we're going to move to tabletop position on our hands and knees. Maybe if you have some knee problems, it's nice to pat your knees with a blanket or a sheepskin or a double mat, whatever works for you, what you have handy. So come on your hands and knees and check your alignment. Your wrists are stacked underneath your shoulders. Your knees are hip-width apart, stacked underneath your hips. And your spine is neutral, straight, gaze down. Spread your fingers out a little bit so you have a good grasp with your hands. And we're going to warm up the body even more. So on an in-breath, bring your right leg out, straightened out, bring it up. And on an exhale, bring your right leg to the right side, straight. And on an inhale, bring your right leg all the way to the left. Maybe tap the foot on the floor. And on an exhale, bring it back to the middle and come down to a little forward fold. And back up on the inhale. Exhale, bring your right leg to the right, straight. Inhale, bring your right leg to the left. Tap your foot on the floor. Exhale, come back to neutral and bend your arms, coming forward, nose to the mat. And inhale, come back up. Exhale, bring your right leg to the right side. Exhale, all the way to the left. Tap the floor. Bring your leg back. Calm down. Bend your elbows. And come back up. And then exhale. Move down your right leg. Come back to tabletop. And take a breath here. Going to move to the other side. Inhale, bring your left leg up straight. Feet are flexed. Toes are pointing down. Breathing out, bring your left leg to the left, straight. Breathing in, bring your left leg all the way to the right. Cross and tap your toe on the floor. Breathing in, coming back. And bend your arms. Nose to the floor. Breathing in, come back up. Breathing out, bring your left leg to the left. Breathing in, come back to the right. Cross and tap your toe. Breathing in, coming back. And coming to the floor. Bend your elbows. Noses to the floor and come back up. Breathing out one more time. Bring your left leg to the left side. Breathing in all the way to the right. Tap your toe on the floor. Coming back to neutral. Bend your arms, your elbows, nose to the mat. And coming up. Exhale, bring your leg down. Come back into your neutral position. Very good. Tuck your toes into the mat. And on an out breath, bring yourself slowly up with bent knees into downward facing dog. Slowly, slowly. Keep your knees bent as much as you need to, as long as you can. Straightening out the arms, fingers are spread wide, lengthening out the whole spine. And when you're on your top of your spine, you can straighten out the knees, maybe walk them out a little bit, warming up in your downward facing dog. Look to your toes, so to relax your neck. Press yourself away from the mat. And when you find your position, come into stillness and take a deep breath in, downward facing dog, in, and sigh it out. Breathe in, look to the front, and slowly walk to the front of your mat. And arrive on the front of your mat, and your knees are bent. To protect your hamstrings. Your belly is on top of your upper legs, glute to your legs, so your knees are probably bent. And you can stay here, clasp opposite elbows, come in ragdoll. Or if you like to release the wrist a little bit after the last pose, you can also put your hands underneath your feet with your palms facing up and your toes are touching the wrists. And bring your weight to the front and the back a little bit, dancing back and forth to release the tension in the wrists. Give the hands a little massage. Wiggle your toes to massage your hands a little bit. Your head is heavy, hanging loose, no tension in the neck. And slowly come to stillness, release your hands. And if you're a ragdoll, you can also release your arms to the mat. And on the inhale, slowly, vertebra by vertebra, coming up, rolling up to a standing position. And coming with the hands in front of the heart, Anjali Mudra. And take a breath. Find your Tadasana. Your feet are hip-width distance apart. If you want to move back and forth a little bit to feel the weight equally divided on your feet. If you feel your weight is equally divided, that's where you land. Come to stillness. Legs are active. Tailbone tucked in a little bit. You can draw your navel in and up. Chin tucked in. Shoulders are away from the ears. Lengthening out into your mountain pose, Tadasana. Close your eyes. And feel you, how you're standing in your mountain pose. Steady, strong. And now is the time to set your intention for this class. Maybe something you want to let go or something you want to empower. Some love you want to send out in the world. Your intention that you can take with you in every breath and each pose throughout this practice. Slowly open your eyes. And on inhale, bring your arms up and overhead. And exhale, hinge from the belly, from the hips, all out the belly, coming down into a forward fold. If you need to bend your knees, please do so. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, step into plank. Exhale, knees down, uncurl the toes, and come in one straight line down to the floor. Opening up your legs a little bit, so your feet are a little bit wider than your hips. Bring your hands next to your face, coming up for baby cobra. Now inhale, draw your nose up, coming out of your back. Into a baby back bend. Maybe you want to lift up your hands so there's no weight on your hands. All the strength is coming from your back. And exhale, come back down. Plant your hands underneath your shoulders. And inhale, help yourself up to tabletop. And exhale, we meet up in downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg, hips are straight, feet are flexed, foot is flexed, and on an exhale, bring your knee to your chest And plant your foot in beneath, between your hands. Lowering down the left knee, uncurling the toes, and inhale, come up for crescent moon. Hands are in the air. And you're going for a little Hanuman crescent moon flow. So on an exhale, bring your arms down and to the back and move your way through the back, stretching out your right leg, coming into Hanuman, monkey goddess pose, monkey god. And on inhale, come back to crescent moon. We're going to do this a couple of times, so exhale, move slowly and gently to the back. If you feel you're wobbly a bit, you can also curl your toes under and tuck them in the mat again, your left foot. Maybe a bit more stability. And inhale, come up for crescent moon. Nose is drawn up in the air. You can look towards your hands. Follow your hands when you're on an out breath. Bring them back. Following your hands with your gaze until you can't go any further. Straighten out your left or right leg and come into Adha Hanuman, half monkey god pose. Inhale, come back up for crescent moon. And exhale, plant your hands next to your foot. Step into your plank. Knees down, uncurl your toes, and on an exhale, bring yourself all the way down to a low plank on the mat. Place your hands next to your face, and on an inhale, bring yourself up, baby cobra. And on an exhale, come down. Come up to all fours, and on an exhale, step towards your plank. Downward facing dog. Inhale, bring your left leg up, three-legged dog, keep your hips stacked. Feet is pointing down, foot is flexed, and on an exhale, bring your knee towards your chest, all the way to the front, bring your weight to the front, and place your foot in between your hands, lowering down the left knee, uncurling the toes, and on the inhale, come up into crescent moon. Arms are stretched up and over, looking towards your hands, sinking into your hips. And we're going to the Adho Hanuman crescent moon flow. Exhale, keep following your hands down and up, stretching out the left leg. And move your weight back, coming into Adho Hanuman. And inhale, bring your hands back to the front and up overhead again. Bring the weight forward into crescent moon. Exhale, move to the back. And inhale, come back up into crescent moon. Last time, exhale, slowly, with control, move to the back, straightening out your left leg. Bring your arms to the back and up. And inhale. Move your way to the front, arms up and overhead. Crescent moon. Exhale, bring your hands next to your left foot. Tuck your right toes in and step into your plank. Your plank, your whole body's active, your wrists are underneath, your shoulder blades, gaze is down. Back is straight. Check your alignment and exhale. Bring your knees down. Uncurl the toes and in one straight line, come back down. Place your hands next to your face. Feet are some bit wider than the mat or than the hips. And inhale, come up for baby cobra. Maybe you want to lift your hands again to make sure there's no weight on your hands. And exhale, come back down. Nose to the mat. Inhale, move through all fours. And exhale to downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the front. And walk to the front of your mat. Halfway lift. Feet are hip-width distance apart. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come all the way up. Arms up and overhead. And exhale, hands in front of the heart. And I move to the next vinyasa. Inhale, arms all the way up. And exhale, come into your forward fold. Hinge from the hips, hollow out the belly. Forward fold, inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, step to your plank. Exhale, knees down, uncurl the toes and move down in one straight line. Make sure your alignment is okay, so your feet are a little bit wider than your hips again. Press your pelvic bone into the mat. Keep your hands underneath your shoulders this time. We're going for a full cobra, Bhujangasana. And on the inhale, bring your body up. Press away with your hands into the mat. Coming into a full expression of cobra. Your pubic bone is still in the mat, so don't come up too far. Keep your pelvic area glued to the mat. Your shoulders are away from the ears. Your nose is drawn up a little bit. So your spine and your neck are one curve. And exhale, come back down. Nose to the mat. Inhale, help yourself up to all fours. And exhale, down to downward facing dog. Inhale, left, right leg up. Hips are stacked in one straight line. Foot is flexed. Feet are pointing down. And on exhale, bring your knee to the chest. Weight forward and plant your foot in between your hands. And come up in high lunge, warrior one. You can keep your left leg or foot straight, or if you want, you can also swivel it down if it feels better for you. See what feels best for your stability. If you keep your toes in the mat and your heel up, you're more straight with your hips. And this is maybe better if you have your foot on the floor. You have a bit more stability, but it's easier, much harder to keep your hips in one straight line. So choose your own warrior one, what feels best for your body. Okay, come back into the warrior one. And on the exhale, bring your arms into cactus arms and come into a little back bend. Gaze is looking up to the ceiling. And inhale, come back up, arms up, warrior one. Exhale, bring the arms down and grasp them, interlace them behind your back. Move your hands away from your body. Your shoulder blades are squeezed together. And then exhale, bring your body forward into a forward fold. Your arms are coming up into humble warrior. Arms are straightened up and overhead. See how far you can bring your arms up into a humble warrior. Make sure your right knee is stacked up top of your foot, top of your ankle. So not over your ankle to protect your knee. And inhale, come back up into warrior one. Arms up and exhale, bring them down to the mat, step into your plank. Stay in plank here. Swivel your feet to the right side of the mat. And come into a side plank. So your right arm is stacked underneath your shoulder. And an inhale, draw your left arm up, all the way up into a side plank. If this is too much for you, you can always lower down your right knee to come on your right knee looking up and towards your left hand. Keep on breathing. Active. Push yourself away from the mat. One more in breath. And on the out breath, come back down into your plank. And move through your vinyasa. Bring your knees down. Uncurl your toes and come all the way down in one straight line to the mat. Breathing in, bring yourself up into a cobra. Keep your pelvic bone on the mat, glued on the mat. Don't come too far up. Shoulders away from the ears. And exhale, calm back down. Nose towards the mat. Inhale to all fours and exhale. Meet up in downward facing dog. Take a moment to collect your breath. Breathe it in and out. Maybe you want to sigh it out. On the next inhale, left leg comes up. Hips are in one straight line. Foot is flexed. Feet are pointing down. And on an exhale, bring your knee towards your chest. Move your weight forward and plant your feet in between your hands. Inhale, come up for high lunge, warrior one. And again here, choose your position. So either keep your heel, your right heel from the mat, or swivel wheel on your right foot to come in your warrior one. See what feels best to you. Looking up into your hands. And breathe. Deep, long, steady breaths. Breathing out, bring your hands down. Clasp them, interlace them behind your back. Stretching out your arms. Squeezing your shoulders together and then exhale, bring your weight forward. Come into a forward fold, humble warrior. And bring your arms straight up and forward. Keep on breathing. Legs are active, steady and stable. One more breath in and out, and on the next in breath, come back up into warrior one. And on the next out breath, bring your arms down and step into your plank. Check your alignment. See that your fingers are also spread it out again. Left hand is underneath the left shoulder. Swivel the legs to the feet to the left side. And on inhale, draw the right arm all the way up into a side plank. Active. Your whole body is active, pushing away from the mat. And if you need to, you can always lower down your left knee for a modification on side plank. Keep on breathing. Keep on pushing yourself out of the mat. Gaze is up towards your thumb or focused in front of you. That feels better for your neck. One more breath in. And on the out breath, come back to plank. Bring your knees down, uncurl your toes and move all the way down in one straight line towards the mat. Find your alignment for cobra. Hands underneath the shoulders. And the inhale, press out of your hands into your cobra. Shoulders away from the ears. Back and neck are in one curve. And exhale, come back down. Inhale, come up to all fours. And exhale, Bring your knees as wide as the mat. Bring your weight towards your feet and come into resting child's pose for a couple of breaths. You're doing great. Take your time to recuperate a little bit. Breathing into the belly. Mini rest. One more deep breath in and out. And the next in breath, help yourself up and come into a downward facing dog. Inhale, look to the front and step, walk or jump to the front of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. And inhale, come all the way up, arms up and overhead. And exhale, hands in front of the heart. Good. You can stay in front of the mat. I will just turn around so you can see me a little bit better. Going to our Utkatasana flow. Bring your feet next to each other. Big toes are touching. Your knees are glued together. And your... I always forget the word in English. The back of your heels are maybe slightly apart. Depends on how your anatomy works. So, but the important thing is that your big toes are touching and your legs are glued together. Inhale, bring your arms up. And exhale, bend your knees and come sit down in your chair pose. Arms are straight next to the ears. Look down, see if you can still see your toes. If you don't see your toes, then you're too much to the front. Bring your weight back a little bit. Your tailbone is tucked under, so your spine is straight. No hollowing out of the back. And keep on breathing. Legs are active. Belly button is drawn in and up. Utkatasana, intense pose or chair pose. One more breath, deep breath in. And on an exhale, bring your hands towards your heart. And bring your left elbow to your right knee. Maybe you have to bend a little bit deeper to reach. See what you need. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, push in your hands. And push yourself into a side twist. Utkatasana side twist. Gaze is looking up. Drishti is up to the ceiling. And your knees are glued together. Strong foundation, strong base. Completely breathe out, hollowing out the belly. See if you can come a little bit deeper into the side twist. You can stay here or straighten out the arms. Bring your left arm hand to the floor and your right arm, draw your right arm up. You have to bend a little bit deeper to come here into an extended side twist in Utkatasana. It's totally fine, whatever variation you choose. See where you are today. Everything is optional. Last deep breath in. Breathing out, coming back to straight chair, Anjali Mudra. And on an exhale, come all the way down in a yogi squat with closed knees. So we're going to try the side crow. So if you have your blanket, maybe it's good to put it on next to you on the mat. So if you're going to move on your hands and you move forward, then you have something to fall on if you fall out of balance. So you're in your yogi squat, knees are squeezed together, and you bring your arms to the right side, strong arms. Your fingers are spread out, and bring your knee on your upper arm and your side of your whole leg as on both arms. So see if you can balance out on your arms, moving back and forth a little bit, shifting your weight to the front and to the back. Trying out the balance on your arms, see how strong your arms are. You can either stay and keep doing this. And if you want to come in side crow, plant your leg on the top of your arms, so on your upper arms. Your gaze is down and forward a little bit. Neck is straight. And see if you can shift your weight forward, all the way forward. Pressing your side of your leg in your arms, squeezing. And see if you can lift your feet off of the mat. And come out if you have enough. Just trying. Maybe you want to try another time. Try it again. Squeezing your elbows and your upper arms in the side of your leg. And come into side crow. And if you fall out, no problem. You can always try again. And if it's enough, come back to the middle. Good. Inhale, move way up into your Utkatasana. One more breath here. Inhale, come up. And exhale, hands in front of the heart. Whew, shake it out a little bit before we go to the other side. You're doing great. Good. Okay, find your alignment again. So big toes are touching, knees are glued together, whole legs are glued together. And on the inhale, bring your arms up overhead and come into your Utkatasana. See if you can still see your toes, otherwise bring your weight back a little bit. Keep on breathing. Arms are active and straight next to the ears. One breath in, and exhale, bring your hands and Jali Mudra in front of the heart. Bend a little bit deeper and bring your right elbow towards your left knee. Make sure your knees stay together and not move one to the back and one to the front. They need to be next to each other for the best alignment. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, press away through your hands into your side twist, hollowing out the belly, and your gaze is moving upwards. Keep on breathing. You can use your Ujjayi breath, your oceanic breath, to help you steady in this posture. Ease into this posture. Find the comfortable in the uncomfortable. You can either stay here or bring your right hand to the mat. And on inhale, draw your left arm all the way up, straight. Come into an extended side twist, Utkatasana. Gaze is looking up towards the thumb. Choose your variation. Maybe this side is different from the other side. Just explore how your body is feeling today, what it needs, where it wants to be challenged and where it doesn't want to be challenged. Exhale, bring your hands together again. move to the front and come sit down into your closed knees, yogi squat. Bring your little crash pad to the other side of the mat. The other side of you, your left side. Bring your knees glued together, your arms to the left side. Fingers are spread out. And try to balance your weight on your arms. Bring your whole side of your leg on the top of your arms, on your upper arms, and move back and front a little bit, playing with the weight from your hands to your legs, to your feet, your arms to your legs. And again, you can stay here if this is enough for you. If you just want to explore this movement, that's totally fine. If you want to see if you can do the balance, then move your leg on top of your upper arms. Squeeze your arms, press them into your leg, looking down and a little bit forward. Bring your weight forward on your arms, on your hands, and see if you can lift your feet from the mat into a side crow. If you fall out, no problem. You have your crash pad with you. You can always try again. Good. One more time. Whew. Keep on breathing. Don't forget to breathe. And come back to the front of the mat. Beautiful. Come back up to your Utkatasana. Chair pose. One more long, deep breath in and out here. And inhale, come all the way up. And shake it out. Good. Whew. You're doing amazing. Okay. I'm going to bring my little knee pad here again. I'm coming to the front of the mat. Find your Tadasana feet. Take a moment to breathe in and out. If you feel a little bit dizzy after this balance and coming up and down again, you can move your head to the left and the right with closed eyes, slowly to release the dizziness and come to the front again. Open your eyes. Inhale, arms all the way up and overhead. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, step into your plank. And now you can choose your own vinyasa. So either knees down, lie down cobra, or come to chaturanga and an upward facing dog. So choose whatever feels best to you in the moment. And we meet each other on an exhale in a downward facing dog. Take a moment of stillness here. Maybe you want to sigh it out. You just did some hard work, so you can have some rest here. We go into the cooling down now. Inhale, come on your toes and move your weight forward into a plank. Exhale, knees down onto your toes and come lying all the way down. Bring your hands on the top of your mat and come on your forearms. Going to move to Sphinx. And inhale, draw yourself up into a Sphinx pose. Your pelvic floor stays on the mat. Your feet are a little bit wider than your hips. Hands are planted and rooted into the mat. Press yourself away and to a baby back bend, not such a big back bend. See how far you can come to the Sphinx pose. Shoulders away from the ears. Relax your gluteus muscles. If it's too much, you can always come down a little bit. Bring your gaze down. And breathe. Steady the breath, slowing down. Breathe into the belly. Deep, long breaths in and out. Breathing out, bring your right hand underneath your face, underneath your head, and move over to the right side, coming into Sleeping Buddha. Your left hand is in front of you to help you steady in the pose. And take hold of your left knee and bring the left knee, squeeze it into your chest, doming the spine a little bit to release the back. If you have trouble with your balance, you can bend your right knee a little bit. Bring your nose towards your knee while you still support your head with your hand. Breathing in the whole back area of your body. And exhale, let go. Come back into your Sphinx pose. Pelvic areas on the floor. Hands are spreaded, fingers are spreaded. Hands in the mat, forearms in the mat. Relax your gluteus muscles. Gaze is soft, or maybe your eyes are closed. Winding down. Bring your attention to where you feel the stretch in your body. Breathe towards that area. A little yin practice in a yang class. Deepening breath. Deep inhales and long exhales. Last cycle of breath here. And move your hand on your face on the left side, your left arm, and roll on your left side into Sleeping Buddha on the other side. You can support yourself with your right hand in front of your chest. And take hold of your left knee and bring it towards your chest. Squeeze yourself into a little Sleeping Buddha ball. Your nose towards your knee. If you need to bend your standing or your lying leg, that's fine. I'm sorry, it's your right knee in towards your chest.
I'm a bit off with my left and right today. Releasing your back. Breathing into your whole back of your body. Then exhale, let go.
And roll on the back of your back, on your back, into a supine position. Bend your knees and bring your foot towards your pelvic area and take hold of your feet with your hands, opening up the knees. Breathe here, lying yogi squat. The next in-breath, bring your nose towards your feet. Activate your abdominal muscles. And out-breath, calm back down. Breathing in, bring your nose towards your feet. Maybe even try to bring up your sacrum from the floor. So making a squeeze your body inside one little ball again. And exhale, release. Plant your lower back on the floor again. Release your head on the floor, on the mat. Inhale one more time. Bring your nose towards your toes. Squeeze yourself into a little ball. Your sacrum comes off of the floor a little bit. And exhale. Gently let go. Bring your foot with your hands towards your chest. Your face coming into happy baby. Your knees are towards your armpits. And if it's not easy for you to take hold of your foot, you can also place your hands on the back of your thighs. Come into a happy baby pose that suits you. Maybe you want to roll from left to right a little bit. Make sure your whole spine is on the floor. From your neck to your sacrum, everything is touching the floor. If you roll it out, you massage your lower back on the floor. And maybe you want to keep it still. Opening the hips after all this hard work. Releasing. Exhale, let go of the feet. Bring the feet together. Bring them back to the mat. And opening up the hips. Let the knees drop down to the floor. Fall down into a supine. Hip opening. Butterfly. Arms are relaxed. A little bit away from the body. Palms are facing up. Surrender to gravity. Let your body become heavy into the mat. Let go of all the tension in your body. Opening up the hips. Opening up the heart. This can be a quite vulnerable pose. So if you feel a bit vulnerable, it's totally understandable. If it's too much, you can always come out of the pose. Close your knees. And otherwise, stay a little bit longer here. Breathing in and out deeply into the belly. Maybe your legs are shaking a little bit. And no minor from all the hard work. It's totally fine.
Your next inhale, help your legs, your knees back in towards each other. And bring your knees towards your chest and roll up in a little ball. Give yourself a big hug. Bring your nose to your chest, to your knees. And release. Scoot your hips over to the left side. And then an out breath, bring your knees to the right side, opening up your arms in a T shape. Bring your gaze towards the right side. Come into nourishing twist, supine twist. You can close your eyes. Maybe help your knees down a little bit. With your left hand. Keep your shoulders both on the mat, if possible. Your whole body, let go of all the tension in your muscles. Deepen your breath in and out. On your next inhale, help your knees up again. Move your hips towards the left. And then exhale, bring your knees down to the right. For supine twist on the other side. Gaze to the left. Maybe you help your knees down with your right hand. And relax, surrender to the pose. Keep on breathing, slow, deep, gentle breaths in and out. Your next in breath, bring your legs back to the middle. Bring your foot down on the mat and see if you can find your book or your block for the last pose before we go into Savasana. This is a restorative inversion. Bring your block underneath your sacrum and place your sacrum on top of it. Come lying down, excuse me, bring your hands resting next to your body and hand palms are facing up, excuse me again, and on the in-breath bring your legs up, straighten them out into the air and surrender yourself to this nourishing inversion. Try to find a spot where your legs stay in the air without any effort. Find that sweet spot, point zero. You can just be quieting the body and quieting the mind. Breathing in and out. Closing the eyes. Feel your whole body from your toes to the top of your head. Maybe following your breath in and out. One more deep in and out breath here. And then your next out breath, bring your legs down. Remove the block or the book from under your sacrum and come lying down for Shavasana. Choose your position, either lying on your back. You can also lie on your belly if that feels better for you. Widening your legs. Feet are as wide as the mat. Your feet are dropping out. Arms are a bit away from the body. Relaxed, hands, palms are facing up. Or maybe you place your hands on your belly or your heart. If you feel you need some support for your back, you can put some pillows underneath your knees or come into a constructive rest pose. If you have an eye pillow, you can use it on your eyes and put a blanket over you to keep you warm. And a blanket also helps to keep the energy in and help it integrate into your body. The heaviness of the blanket helps the energy contain in your body and helps the integration process of all the hard work you've done today. And when you find your position, your last pose, final relaxation, don't move again if you can. Stay as still as possible. And surrender every out breath. You sink deeper into your mat. Come to complete stillness and ease. would like to read a little quote for you from Rupi Kaur. It was when I stopped searching for home within others and lifted the foundation of home within myself. I found there were no roots more intimate than those between a mind and body that have decided to be whole. Start deepen your breath, coming back to this space and time on your mat. Waking up the body with every breath. Maybe wiggle your fingers and toes to waking up a little bit more. Move your head from left to right. Stretching yourself all the way out or curl up in a ball. Giving yourself one last big hug. Before you move to the side. And come back up seated on your mat, your hands in front of you. Eyes closed. Thank yourself for this practice. I want to thank you for practicing with me. It's beautiful to be here with you. Bring your hands to your forehead for kind thoughts. Your hands to your lips for kind speech. And your hands to your heart for kind intentions. Namaste. Sat Nam.